Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Now, in this short tutorial, I will show you how easily you can create a UI scroll view for your Xcode projects. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, now, if you take a look at the testing easy UI scroll view, you will see how easy it is. It's just, well, one line of code. I have added these new lines so you can see all of the elements that we can configure here. But basically, this could be just one line of code. And yeah, you have to have a DScrollView, a container, and an element. Basically, a DScrollView is a UI scroll view. And these two, the container and the element, are a part of the framework that I will show you today. Now, let's jump right into it and start off with a brand new project. So let's go to File, New, and Project. And I will choose the single view application template from Rebeloper. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I'm just taking off the main.storyboard, and you can click the link down below for the resources where you can create custom Xcode templates. Okay, let's click on next here, and I will name this easiest scroll view. Okay, and I won't embed it in a navigation controller because navigation controllers always take care of the top safe area problems, but I want to show you the whole thing. So let's click on next here, and I will drop it into my YouTube here, videos, today, and code. Okay, I will create a GitHub repository so you can take a look at the code later on. Okay, let's just resize this and start working on it. Okay. What you first need to do is download the resources, and you will find the link in the description for that. And you will see that here we have four DScrollView ... files. So let's create a new group here. We'll call this DScrollView, and let me just drag and drop all of these four files. Okay, there we go. And click on finish there. Now, if you wish to, you can take a look at them, go and read what they are all about. Well, basically, it's a helper for UI scroll view. And one final thing while we are here, let's just drag and drop this image here to our assets folder. Okay, now why UI scroll view? Because, well, it is kind of hard to work with scroll views in UIKit. So that is why I wanted to create this helper so you can easily add scroll views to your container. Okay, let's go to our root view controller, and first of all, let's create our scroll view. So let scroll view, that will be, let's say, the scroll view. There we go. Or you could use UI scroll view. This is just a type alias. Let me just show you this, the scroll view. It is just simply a UI scroll view that has keyboard dismiss mode of interactive, but you could use just simply a UI scroll view. So next up, let's create our container. Let scroll view container. That will be of type the scroll view container. And let's see what we have here. We have, basically, this is a UI stack view, if you take a look at the code down below this. And we want to have this initializer with an axis and a spacing. So the axis should be, in our case, vertical, and the spacing, let's say, add in here 10. Okay. So one final thing we need to add in here is an element. So scroll view element. And I will just add in here one element, but I will show you in the test where it has two elements. So the scroll view element, and what this basically you need to have is to set a height or a size or a height with background color. So I would just choose, of course, if the axis would be horizontal, you could choose the width option. So I would choose the height one, and I would add in here 1200, and the background color, let's have in here purple. But of course you should choose white if that is best for you. So yeah, that is it. We have a scroll view, and we need to initialize it with a container view and an element. Now, what do we want to add in here? Well, let's add a simple label. So let label equals UI label, and yeah, that is basically it. I will just add here, let's see, view dot background color equals white, and dot white, sorry about that, dot white, and I will add a text to our label. So label dot text equals, so next up, let's add our scroll view. And currently we are just going to add our scroll view to our view, so the view controller's view, but we could add this to any other view. So that is the power of the scroll view. So let's just type in view dot and add scroll view. Let's see if we have auto completion here. Let's hit command B so we can have that. So view dot add scroll view. There we go. And we have a few options, and I would choose the one that has all of them. So there we go. Scroll view, that is a D scroll view, and of course it is a UI scroll view, so you can add that as well. So scroll view there with safe area. Now let's see here, what do we have? Let's add a dot there, so we can have the safe area of all bottom, horizontal, leading, none, top, trailing, vertical. So we have a lot. So I will just choose for now, let's see here, vertical. Okay. Has status bar cover, I would choose true here, so I can show you how that looks like. And status bar background color, I will add in here a dot red so we can see it. But of course you should have this to white. And the reason why we have a status bar cover is because this scroll view will scroll all the way up, and you might want to hide the container on the status bar or not. So if it doesn't, then you can set has status bar cover to false and just delete status bar background. Container is our scroll view container, and the elements is an array of views. Well, we have this, you could have any kind of view, of course you can, but it is advisable to have a descroll view element because it sets its height by default. So let's add this scroll view element here. And basically that is it. So before we add our label, let me just build and run and see how all of this looks. Build has succeeded, that is awesome. And while we are there, let me just add these so we can see all of the elements. We go, container and elements. So let's see what we have here. So we have our status bar cover, that is awesome. And we are having this width safe area vertical. So it is clipping to the bottom safe area layout guide. And I don't know if you can see the scroll bar there, but we do have this scrolling, okay? And it is also scrolling underneath the status bar cover. Okay, just so we can see, we want to add, let's see here, the background with image, and with the content mode. So let's just add in here our image. Let's see. Command Shift M to bring up the media library. Let's just drag and drop that in there. Let me just double tap on it so we can basically see this. And the content view, let's say scale aspect fit. Okay, let's build and run one more time and see that basically this image is scrolling. Okay, let's see. There we go. Okay, very great. What else do I want to show you? Well, let's see. Let's set this to fill and let's remove the status bar cover. So let's have this to false and just simply comment out this line and let's see what happens then. Okay, so we do have the safe area guidelines, and if I scroll up, you can see that we want to omit the safe area. Yeah, so it is not it's going underneath because it is basically not going underneath. We want to have a safe area of none. Okay, and then just build and run. Okay, let's see. So as you can see, we have that underneath, and let's just convert this back to true and let's have this as white. Okay, and let's build and run and see the awesomeness. Okay, there we go. Great. And of course you can have this set up for the background, for the container or the scroll view with this awesome new function here with background. And of course you have with background color as well. Now, what else do I want to show you? Let me just create a new scroll view element. So let's have this as 0 and let's have this as 1. And the scale aspect fit, that should be it. Great, and let's have this as only 500 with a height. And what we want to do here is add element 0 with a comma and scroll. Let me just show you what I'm writing here. So scroll view element 1. Let's hit command R and see how that looks. And now you will see that we have our first element. Then we have some spacing, the 10 here, so the spacing of 10, and then we have the second element there. Well, this is just for your convenience. You could add in here as many elements as you wish, but of course one element is more than enough in most of the cases. So let's add our label finally to our, let's say, the second element. So scroll view element 1, add subview and the label. Now you just add it to the scroll view element. So label edge to view and scroll view element 1. Of course you could use tiny constraints or any other constraints just to constrain your element. So let me just remove that so we can see a little bit better. And maybe I need to have this label. Let's see if the text color is white or not. Being that said, it should appear. Okay, so we have our first element and there we go. I am a label. And of course you can center it to your needs and so on. But you should know that these elements are arranged subviews of our UI scroll UI stack view that we have created here under the name of scroll view container. Okay, now that is it. If you want to dive deeper into how the scroll view works, go ahead and take a look at the files and just use it. And it is just a few lines of code, if not only one line of code, to add a scroll view on your projects. Okay, now that is it for me today. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos. Now it is your turn. Go ahead and implement this scroll view into your own apps. And if you do have an easier way to implement UI ScrollView into your apps, do let me know in the comments down below. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.